We will enter the final lap shortly. It doesn't really matter which way you go. Massi is through on Raul Fernandez.
Everybody trying to find the toe, trying to find the clear air. Massi then it is then that should lead over the line to start this last lap. Binder was out wide at the final couple of corners. That's allowed a rain that's to sweep on through. So the podium and the win still very much on for the World Championship leader.
It's the last lap of the race in a thriller here. Madness in Motorland. Aragon, and I thought he was going to lose the front there, but brilliant tight on the brakes. Raul Fernandez retakes the lead.
He has been superb in that first corner on the brakes. Max Coughlin's gone down late on the Austrian at turn 15. Back at the front, Fernandez standing firm. He's under intense pressure here. Will he crack? Massia trying to find a way through up at turn 4.
Oh, that's close. Over.
That was close. Very, very close, but it's still Fernandez that leads.
Darren Binder up the inside of Albert Arenas. They're all trying to jostle for position, and out really wide there is Albert Arenas, and that's
costly. There's going to be some World Championship points potentially lost here. Massia at 7.
What a move.
Seventh heaven for Massia, although he's running a little bit wide. Fernandez sweeps straight back on through. They drop down to the reverse corkscrew for the final time. Rubbing elbows, Fernandez and Massia. Alcoba, that's really close. Really close. There was nearly contact then between the 52 and Massia.
Kitchen sinks being thrown everywhere here in the final lap of this Moto3 race. Can Raul Fernandez hold on to what would be a stunning victory?
And what about Albert Arenas? And he's got work to do to get back on that podium. Massia, oh, he squeezed right out onto the curb now.
That was a bit cheeky, wasn't it? But it's the last lap, and there is so much at stake here for Raul Fernandez. At the moment, he holds on.
Don't you lose one place racing the track limit on the last lap. That's going to be looked at.
Yeah, that's going to be looked at, definitely, by the race direction. Darren Binder trying to hang it around the outside there. It gives him the inside lane. That was brilliantly done from Binder, but he's going to lose drive. Onto the back straight we go. How crucial is this? Massia surely will get him on the slipstream.
Here comes Massia, then we know his Leopard Honda's been a rocket on this back straight, and he sweeps straight on through from Raul Fernandez. Fernandez has a great edge grip in the final couple of corners, but Massia looks like he's got this one covered. Fernandez may well even miss out on the podium here. Binder got him for second place. It's all bunching up in the final corner, and it looks like it's going to be Jaume Massia in Motorland.
Into the slipstream comes Binder, but he won't be close enough. Massia, is he going to win it? He does, from Darren Binder. Fernandez is on the podium for the first time, but what a brilliant victory from Massia. But it will be looked at.
It will be looked at. Normally, it's an automatic demotion of one place on the final lap for exceeding the track limit. It was a bad last lap for Albert Arenas. He took the checkered flag in seventh. He lost crucial World Championship points. Now, this one will be looked at.
What a race it was here in Aragon. But that has to be looked at again, because
right now,
we could see a change.
Right now, Massia is the master of Motorland, but will race direction there. We'll be looking at that one. They will be keeping a very close eye on that one.
Simon, your views on that?
Yeah, my views are he didn't have a choice, you know. Like, it's kind of different if you run wide onto that green and you know you need to use it, you're on your own. But he didn't have a choice, you know. He had the throttle open and Raul run him right to the paint. So I'm hoping they forgive him for that one.
Look at the state of his bike at the front. What's happened to the front of Massia's bike? We need to look at a replay of it, because Massia took an unusual line. That's what the defence of Fernandez will take. He was trying for an inside line that doesn't normally come. Now, Massia could have gone to the right. He decided. What are we looking at
that
here? What's this replay? This
was
on the last lap. We need to see
corner
before that.
Binder, look at that by Binder. That was ruthless up the inside of Raul Fernandez, who did, thankfully, hold on to his first World Championship podium.
What happened to Arenas? He got up into fourth place.
Yeah, and they just got beaten up.
There
was a bit of rubbing, wasn't there, between him and Alcoba. And then he got slipstreamed by both Fanati and John McPhee. What an absolute thriller here in Motorland Aragon. Jaume Massia takes the checkered flag by just 900th of a second for his second career victory. His first since Turmaster.
Oh, that's what's happened to his bike. He's punched it in because he's so happy. Here we go. Another smash as well. I don't really see any need for that, but, you know, emotions run high in Moto3. What we need to see is a replay halfway through that last lap.
All sparing in love and war, I guess.
Is where it happened. Darren Binder, brilliant ride, fantastic ride, a return to the podium for the South African.
Awesome job, absolutely awesome. A great slingshot on Raul Fernandez into the final corner, back on the podium for Binder. Of course, Motorland Aragon's been kind to Motorland Aragon, so we're just hearing that the top three has been confirmed. So Jaume Massia then, congratulations to him.